is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Take action on your ideas. Doing your best means to take action on your ideas. You can have many great ideas in your head, but without action upon an idea, there means no manifestation, no results, and no reward. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 68. NASDAQ is up 20. S&P's up 1.5. Gold contract up $1.40, trading at $12.95 an ounce. You get silver down 4 cents, $15.05 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $1.07, $62.66 a barrel. Light sweet crude, folks, looks like 65 is on the agenda. Now, this is going to get pretty dicey, too, because you have some resistance at 65, but the way we had come down, we came down really fast from the 76 level. But 65 is going to have a little resistance, but we'll see how it comes up to that level. Notes and bonds, you get the 10-year note up 5 ticks, 123.25. 30-year is up 4 ticks, trading at 148.11. And the 10-year right now is yielding 2.476. Low for the year is 2.366. That was generated last week. King dollar. King dollar's up 136 ticks, trading 96.935. King dollar is trying to get to its March 7th high. Bottom line, you're dying on the vine with volume, but guess what? It's getting a lot of help over in Europe because the euro is at lows right now, and looks like it actually broke a consolidation. Now, it didn't break the consolidation with conviction. So what a break with conviction, whether you're going top side or down below, folks, is a wide price spread. And normally you'd also have the volume. Now, the difference with the foreign currency market is the bottom line is that it trades at so many different places, you actually don't have volume. But what you can see is that when we stop, I get this chart up right now, you can see November 12th, bottom line, you're at 112.16. Now, you did break this with conviction on March 7th. That's when the euro went from 113 to 111, and it turned right around, you know, which is really unusual, by the way, with a break this severe. Turns around, gets all the way topside to 114. Now we're back down testing this 111.77 area. We got to 111.84. And bottom line is that number there, that's the whole Brexit deal. What's intriguing about watching the euro is that the euro is a lot weaker than the actual pound is. You know, the pound wants to go to a higher price. So we'll see how this whole thing shakes out. You're at 113.18. The bottom line is that over in the UK Parliament, the only thing they can seem to say on a continual basis is no, no, no. So they're going to have to come to some type of yes at some particular point. S&Ps. What do we got the S&Ps out here? So if we take a look at the S&Ps, what you're going to see, SPY right now, up 21 cents. Really anemic volume out here today. This is pretty intense, actually. You don't see this a lot. We're 29 million shares traded. That should do. Normally, you could put 10 million shares in the last hour. You know, we'll see whether they can do it. Even at 39 million, you know, we did 77 million yesterday. You're going into 214 million. That high there, that we're talking about. This is the downdraft of the October 10th, which when we went from 286 to 277, monster volume. So NDX 100, they're peaking their head up there slightly. Volume 16 million. That's trying to get into the last high, which was the 182.83 that had 42 million. You can see even the NDX 100, that's and the volume is dying on the vine. There's no two ways about that. We're going to take a look at the gold contract, what we have with the gold contract. Gold contract high of today was 1296. The low was 1289. And this baby, and this is what we needed too, by the way. We needed this to get under the lows of the last few days. We broke the low. No, we didn't break the low. We still didn't break the low, the swing low of the March 7th, which is the 1287. But I like how this traded today, because what we did is this. So picture, last Thursday, folks, we came down with monster volume. We came down with 424,000 contracts. We rejected that with lighter volume on Friday, 270. Yesterday, it tried to get higher, and then it closed at the low of the day, which was 237,000. We closed at 291, 1291. Today, pretty cool what it did. Got to 1289, no more sellers, rejected 1289. You're 1295, and anything inside of 1293.30, which was the low of last Thursday, is a good number that it's saying, okay, now we might be able to get into higher price. If we get over and we take a look at the silver market, what you're going to see with the silver market is a big laggard in the aspect of the metals market in general. Silver market out here today got down to a price point of 1490, rejected it, has lighter volume, and this is a nice setup. This is like, you know, you're finishing out the day at the highs of the day, and you did reject the price, and you had about 20,000 less contracts. So this could put us right in shape that we start going topside once again inside that metals market. We go take a look at the GDX. What do you have with the GDX? That's a sideways move. I would have rather the GDX actually get under the low of yesterday, which was 2183. Get a sideways move. That's light volume, so that is actually a toss-up in the aspect of where that baby, you know, would like to go. When you get under the lows, you have lighter volume, you reject it, you go higher, your probability is much higher that you'll just go topside once again. Some of the high-volume equities out here, you have, let's see, we have Bank of America up 23 cents. The ones that are getting smoked out here, you get Walgreens down $8.23. That's getting taken to the cleaners. CVS, same sector. That is, looks like it's going to be breaking a B point. It broke it today. It doesn't have a lot of volume on the break today, but the bottom line is that the way that it's trading right now, I suspect tomorrow it's going to make it run for this low once again. The low we're talking about is 51.93. We made 51.77. You get volume out here. Well, actually, you know, this is interesting, man. It might get the volume. It only needs 21.7 million. It won't take much to do that. You're at 17 right now. We just might get it. Dow Industrials right now are trading down for 67. NASDAQ is up 21. S&P's up 2. Stay right there, folks. Got our man Basil Chapman coming up next with us.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. And folks, don't forget, our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, does an outstanding show here every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter, The Opening Call. Now, he's got a really great workshop coming up tomorrow for all his subscribers. You can be a subscriber right here, right now. The way you do this, you come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see right under featured content, The Opening Call. Basil's going to be the title of this webinar tomorrow night from 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time is Anything Goes. And that's a fact right now in the market. Particularly, it seems like this would be really applicable over in England, Anything Goes, I'll tell you that. What Basil's going to be talking about, he's going to be talking about where we are currently in the market right now, reading the technical tools that will show you where the market is heading, the outlook for 2019-2020. The risk versus the rewards, the specific sectors, including the FANGs. And, of course, this whole workshop is archived, folks. You can, you'll be on your page for an additional 30 days. Really easy to subscribe. You just hit subscribe. You can go for a month, 6 months, a year. All come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Basil Chapman, what's going on? Doing great, man. Yourself?
Very good. Thank you.
Cool, man. Cool. So you got a big workshop coming up.
And we're just about to have another webinar. Wow.
Yeah, I know. I know. You gotta love it.
I'm showing a pattern here in the Dow. This is on the left side. That's the daily. In the middle is the weekly. On the right is the monthly. So you can see this arch formation that I've got in blue. And you can see that 26,241 was the high of the 25th of February.
Yes.
And the high yesterday was 26,280. So we went slightly above that. And we're always looking for a leg D. So let me explain what I'm going to be doing in my webinar. Let me just go to this right now. So the webinar tomorrow, Anything Goes, Stock Markets Key Phase, tomorrow, April the 3rd, 5 o'clock till 6:30. It'll be archived on the page of the subscribers. The reason why I say it's a key phase is because there are levels that I'm going to be talking about that could be could start a very bullish phase, or there's levels that could start a consolidation, and those are the levels that we'll be talking about. Most importantly, you know that I'm always looking for four higher peaks. You go to that peak D, the fourth highest peak in the Chapman wave identification of the low, and then you merely count each successively higher peak. That fourth highest peak is alphabetized, it's A, B, C, D. D is where you start to be careful. So let's just have a look once again at the Dow chart. We're in a D right now, but the MACD, the moving average convergence divergence, has just crossed positive in the stochastic 74%. Very important numbers. Going back to the webinar, the things that I always look for in terms of patterns, oops, let me just get back here, is that I believe that there are only three patterns in the market. One is straight up and straight down. The other is the arch, and you've got a cup formation. Within that, you've got a variation where you can get an inverted V, it's still an arch, or you can get a cup or a V-shaped pattern. But what's really important is that within that context, you can also get a sharp move down and then an arch formation. And as it tests that left side low, if you take that out, that has a special meaning. And on the upside, you saw that in the Dow chart, right? As I showed you, we're testing that left side high. Let me show you something else. We are along the IYT, which is the transportation index. Here we are. We're right back. 192.27 was the high in the daily chart right there on the 19th of February. That was a peak F. It pulled back sharply at 179.55, started a new move up, break trend line resistance. Now, where are we? We're right at 192.40 was the high today. That's 13 cents higher than that previous high. And yet, this could turn out to be a new leg A. Is the transportation index just about to break out? That's what I'm going to be discussing. One of the reasons why, for subscribers, we've tried to get into certain positions that have the potential to be in this next phase is because of these patterns that we've been identifying. And within that context, if you look at the dollar, which what's today? It's the second. So we've got 2 days to go. And that'll be 1 year that we've been long the dollar since April the 4th, 2018.
That's pretty wild.
It is. And from the 90 level, it's hit 97.71 twice. What are the patterns we're looking for? Look how fascinating this is. There's that cup formation. Within that, you've got a little V-shaped formation. 97.71 was the high back, I think it was about the 11th of March. And today we've gone to a high of 97.52. We are 20 cents away from breaking that high to start a leg D in the weekly chart and a leg C in the monthly. And look at these arch, these cup formations. Look, cup formation, cup formation, cup formation. And look at the big one in the monthly. So these are the patterns that I'm going to be showing, demonstrating, teaching during the webinar. At the same time, I'm going to be talking about the opposite. If you look at, I'm going to just for the moment go to gold, you'll see that gold has the inverse, and there was a huge cup pattern right here in the gold from the 1353 level back in last year. I think it was somewhere around June, pulls back to 1167, it comes right back, retested at 13, just under that level. That was about 5 weeks ago. And now it's starting to pull back. And there's a little bit an H pattern that we were looking at moments ago. What did I say? We're looking for peak Ds. There it is in the daily. So all of this is going to be relevant. I'm talking about areas of the market that I think are looking much better now that should be maybe not necessarily leaders, but they should have a very good move to the upside in the next 6 to 8 months. I'm also going to be talking about the pattern that I'm looking for 2019. I'm looking at the socioeconomic. I always look at the, where's this chart? I'd like to show something here. I always find this fascinating. How do you go from, look, this is the Mozart era. Look how the men used to dress. They had all this fancy garb, and you had this the little wigs that they wore, and this is a fashion from today. So things look like they change over a period of time, but we always come back to it. We do. I mean, this is the way it is. Human nature doesn't change. We
That's go pretty
from
good.
Excessiveness to sparsity. Look at this. Yeah, this is during the period of Marie Antoinette that was very tumultuous, what do you call it? A period of great tumult back in the 1790s. It just happens to be a little revolution over there in France. This is Marie Antoinette style dresses. And here we are. This is a contemporary dress in 2018 or 19, 1.5 million for this dress.
Really?
And yeah, and I wanted to talk about how do we get to this particular period where excessivity, I call it excessivity, there's a certain wealth effect and it's usually created by the stock market, that starts to have people spending, and then the people who really spend, these are the people, the ones who spend money that some people might not even earn in a lifetime.
Right.
And the other thing is automobiles. Look at this. This is a, what, which one is this? This is the Hispana Suiza. It's a car that is, it has 1,000 horsepower, and it costs $1.7 million, and it has all the accoutrements that we're looking for excessivity, you know, all the little bumps and grinds. And this is what I'm going to talk about, and the relationship today, and why this market is a very unusual market, and that there are certain sectors that should do extremely well this year.
And folks, the way you come into it, just come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to go to featured content, the opening call, check it out. Baz, you have a great one, safe one. We look forward to show tomorrow.
Thank you very much, Tom. You too.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now are down 78. You get the NASDAQ up 22. S&P's up 1.5. And let's go over and take a look at the transports as well as the XLF. What we had out here, folks, yesterday you had big buying, no doubt, in the transports as well as the XLF. What's intriguing out here today is that if we start with the transports, you're going to see bottom line, you got right to the swing point from the 21st of February, and you gave it up. 10,673. We hit it 10,701. Bottom line is that now we're at 10,619. you know, gets over it, closes underneath it, and that's, you know, you're slamming right into this downdraft that had been out there from December 4th. Bottom line is that, you know, this baby can pull right back in about a heartbeat. XLF, same type of setup in the XLF, which is pretty amazing. XLF, they had buying come in yesterday. Yesterday you did 62 million shares. Now, this never made it to the swing point. We did get 34 million today, bottom line, to see if they could do 40 million or something. But same setup, man. Bottom line, this baby's coming into 104 million. So those two actually look like they are one day wonders out here, which is going to be pretty wild, man, if that's what we get. Because when that came in spades, meaning that buy-in yesterday. There's no two ways about that. In both sectors, in fact, inside the transportation sector, there wasn't one equity that was in the negative. We're going to take a look at Delta. Delta came out today. Numbers, bottom line is that that got a pop out here today. But Delta's up $3.24. And when you do look at the Delta in general, it's been basically at this high for quite some time. You know, we bring this back all the way from January of 2015. This has been a high-end consolidation, and we'll see whether they can get any more juice. Walgreens, CVS, they're getting smoked. Big time, too. Let's see. No, Walgreens is... WBA. So, Walgreens today come out with numbers, disaster numbers. There's no growth whatsoever, and they think they're going to do in the double digits. Broke a B point, has monster volume on the break. This is a 51. It's a 10-point A to B. Well, actually, make sure of this, okay? No, it's 15 point, doesn't it? 74, yeah, 60. So, yeah, price projection on this is 51. You're at 55 right now. And then on top of that, this is what a break this is, man. This is intense. Yeah, so we now, you're back to 2013, and we start looking at that $50, $51 number. That's going to bring you somewhere into May of 2013. It's a big number. CVS looks like it's just building cars right now. We'll see whether, you know, bottom line is that, let's see. Yeah, 30 minutes. I don't think we'll get the volume. It's a close call, though. If someone dumps it at the close, all you need right now is 2 million shares. We've done 18.5, and you can get it. And if that's what you get, this is a monster ABC down, because your 8-point on this, I'll do it conservatively. So when you're doing ABC structures, folks, right, up or down, this one's a good one to really explain what you look for, what you take as the A point. So you have an A point up here that could be an A point on February 19th. And then what you had is this. On February 19th, you gap down from 70 all the way down to 65. So you get a big gap. So when you're measuring an ABC structure, what you want to do is that you want to take the bottom of that. That would be the most conservative way of doing it, because that's a gap is considered another swing. So you take the bottom of that, which is 65, a 51 is your B, let's call it 52 because it's 93. So you get 12 bucks, 13 bucks. And that would get you a 44 A to B equals C to D inside CVS. And if we bring this back, and ooh, this is a mess too, look at this. Yeah, they're both going the exact same place. They're both going, this is, actually, CVS is going back to February of 2012. So this is going to be, now, what you're also going to see, and now watch this. This is so dangerous for the marketplace. It's amazing, actually. So what you have is you've actually done 100% move of the move that took off from December of 2012. And what you're also going to see up here, and this is where the danger part comes, that this escalation in price from 2012, $31, all the way up to 113, you just didn't have volume. All the way up, it starts contracting in a huge way. First time off the high was the highest monthly volume we had, 117 million. You go sideways for another 8 months. You go, you take your next leg down with 230 million from 84 to 63. You go sideways for another year, and yet you're seeing the huge monster expansion of volume here, folks. This is a big decisive break. In fact, I can do this. It's a close call. Yeah, it's really not a straight, it's a consolidation. Yeah, it looks to me like 44 is game here. That's gonna be pretty intense, because what it's also doing, let me just do this for a second. RV, so who else is in this space? This space is, Rite Aid. Yeah, so bottom line is that, the drugstore scene in general looks like it's changing. I'm not sure whether the middle is getting taken out of it, by other administrators inside the drug business, or in fact, is the cold remedies, that type of front of the counter versus back of the counter. So back of the counter would be your prescription drugs. Front of the counter is, as we go through these stores, cold remedies in themselves are huge sellers, right? Cold, right now we have, allergies. I mean, people have a huge problem with allergies. That's a big money maker from. Something's going on there, though. Both of those equities are in bad shape. No two ways about that. Let's go take a look at JP Morgan Chase. So JP Morgan, that had a good day out there yesterday. Okay, it's up 51 cents today. Yesterday, bottom line, got the price going. And this consolidation here, we'll see how it handles 106. Right now, you're at 105.55. Berkshire Hathaway, that's still the largest weighting structure inside the XLF, and not much action there, but this didn't get over, it did get over the high yesterday. Okay, so bottom line, you're over the high, you're going to close underneath it. That's a subtle deal, but bottom line is that it's really surprising that we haven't got the type of follow through, particularly just for one day. Facebook, we've got some action in Facebook here. Look at this, up $5.82. And that actually has volume behind the move. Let's see what's going on Facebook. So they're coming out with numbers on the 24th of April. Yeah, bottom line is that there's buyers out here on Facebook. That's the bottom line. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN and you'll find the Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow down to 58. NASDAQ is up 24. S&P's up 3. You got a sideways move out here. That being said, let's go over and take a look at the NQs. So NQ M9, because what we have had, the NQs, you've got a steady movement topside here. And this will be interesting coming into the close. We're looking at that Facebook. So Facebook's definitely caught a bid. Now, the NQs, folks, the high that was generated out here and gave it up pretty quick, which was on the 22nd, is 75.44. We've hit 75.32 thus far. If we go inside the NDX 100 and take a look at strength versus the weakness, you have Wynn Casinos is up 4.6%. We'll go back to that. That's the second day that's up good. Facebook is up 3.3%. You got Alexa Pharmaceutical up 2.9%, and Western Digital is up 2.6%. On the downside, it's all about Walgreens, down 13%. You get JD.com off 3, Mylan Pharmaceuticals off 2.8, and Fox is off 2.3. Let's go over to Wynn for a second. So Wynn, this is quite a move, man. Yeah, this is quite a move. So this is taking out the 133.70. This is an ABC up. Look at this. Okay, so this is going to get really interesting watching how this thing shakes out. So what you have is this. Let's see. Your B point is 133. Your A is 90. How about that? You get $43. Your C is 114. Yeah. 157. 157 is the number on this. Yeah. This is a nice ABC coming off the bottom. Now, the thing that's really wild is that, you know, when this thing started up yesterday, what you had is that it looked that this was the buying was coming from the aspect that in Macau, China, which of course these casinos make a huge amount of money. In fact, they make the bulk of their money over there. Their revenues were flat and they were supposed to be down. That's a big heads up that, particularly when you look at the Shanghai market, that this thing wants higher price. What's intriguing here now is that inside the headlines out here today, now Wynn has a $2.7 billion casino that's going to be opening in Boston in June, folks. And right now, the license, if you listen to the news, their license is at risk. If you look at the stock, their license isn't at risk. that's the way this is shaking out right now. So we'll see how this shakes out, because they had a report filed Tuesday in connection with the Massachusetts Gaming Commission investigation to allegations of sexual harassment at Wynn, included Wynn's testimony of an event that he is saying started his downfall. And what it was a manicurist. Bottom line, he ended up having sex with the manicurist. She claimed that she was getting raped. He was claiming that no, that wasn't the deal. Bottom line is that He had paid $7.5 million to settle the deal. And what's happening right now is that this allegation actually, the full allegation as I just read it across, hadn't actually come out. And the Massachusetts commissions are saying, well, you know, they still got to basically license this deal. And of course, Wynn is gone out of the deal. But this is going to be intriguing watching just this play out. The reason that I'm saying intriguing watching it play out, because you can see with the stock is saying that, hey, guess what? Wynn's gone. That's out of the way. We're gonna win this case. And Massachusetts is going to give me the license to open that baby up. So June's right around the corner. That's the real bottom line. It is literally right around the corner. And that baby is a nice ABC up. Let's go to Las Vegas Sands and see if they got the same thing happening. Because these things like trading together, yeah, they do. Okay. You know what? I bet this is about China. This is about China. I suspect. You know why? Because, okay, Las Vegas Sands, another ABC up. B point is 62, A is 47, so what, $15? C, 78, 73. Yeah, these things are on the move, man. Yep, 73. And watch this, folks. This makes sense, because if we go over to the Shanghai market now and you take a look at Shanghai, Shanghai came off this bottom with, it was amazing, actually. This is not an ABC up because it had slightly lighter volume, but this is quite a move. If you go back to January 4th, the Shanghai market was at 2440. You're at 3176. Monster volume all the way up, too. This is real buying. So I suspect what you're going to see, look at this, yeah. We came in last night with 44 billion, the night before with 46 billion. Now the B point at 58, so it's not an ABC up, but this thing wants to go to 4,000, and we're only at 3,000 right now. And if you get that, this was so bizarre. Picture this, we started at 2,400, but that's when Shanghai moves, like, let me tell you something, it moves. And I suspect what you have happening here is that number one, you want to go to that 3,500 be the next number. You take out 3,500, and then you really get some big action. Fundamental, what it looks to me, is that I would say that, yeah, their factories had slowed down, you know, get a million trade deals happening, or no, non-trade deals, all of the above. Guess what? It's a big world out here, folks. And their factories are going topside again. And it's real possible that, yeah, it was the last year and a half. Actually, let's just look at this chart again, because I want to see how long this has been going down. So picture, if we pull up. Okay, so I'm going to go first. I'm going to go for 3 years. Yeah, so check this out. So it started its downward path. Well, that's not bad. It started its downward path in February. Oh, it went for a full year. Yeah. February of 2018 all the way down to December of January of 2019. So you were down for a full year. Let me see just prior to that. Yeah. So that was, I bet that's exactly what happened. That's the whole downdraft. That's when the factories kept doing less business, bottom line. Now they basically, they popped up. They got above the 50 line, just like our ISM. Once it gets above the 50 line, you know that you're going topside once again. They got above the 50 line. You start putting that together with those casinos in Macau, China. You can see where Wynn wants to go, Las Vegas Sands wants to go. It's a big number. You know, and what's going to be intriguing here is that Wynn is a good weighting structure inside the NDX 100. Apple is up $3. Not enough juice. Apple's only got 18 million shares. That's going into 42. That is not going to be enough to sustain higher price for Apple. Amazon is basically tomorrow. Tomorrow, folks, is Whole Foods Day for Amazon. They're reducing lots of prices by 20%, including meats. So including meats is a big one. Dow Industrials down 62, NASDAQ up 25, S&P's up 2.5. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today and up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow down 66, NASDAQ up 24, S&P's up 2.5. Bottom line, you get a sideways move out here, folks. And you're going to have light volume. Inside the commodity markets out there, let's go look at gasoline. So you get unleaded trading up $1.6%, are up $3.03 at $1.92. Now, it's going to get intriguing here is that, let me pull this back a bit. Yeah, this is XB1, because, of course, we know oil wants to go higher. When I looked at this yesterday, yeah, that's the difference. So when I looked at this yesterday, this is what it's intriguing. So the oil market, the barreled oil market, you know, bottom line, you know, you can see, I can see that going up another $4 or $5 pretty easy. The gasoline market, though, bottom line is that there's some heavy resistance at like 196. Which in our particular case, that's pretty good because, of course, that's what we all use is gasoline, is unleaded, you know. And we'll see how this shakes out. But there's a lot of flack at this. So they're different looking charts, and the reason they're different looking charts is that when gasoline took a dive in a big way in October of 2018, $2.15 wholesale, down $1.24 in December. Now you're just coming back up to that level, whereas the barrel oil did not. That was a one-way track all the way down. Came off those levels, start building cars all the way back topside. We're going to take a look at the XAU, the HUI, inside the gold market out here. XAU, bottom line, is still in good shape. You know, you have higher lows in the XAU, and the gold bugs index actually is stronger than that. Stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming back with some numbers after the close. Dow Industrials down 71, NASDAQ up 22, S&P's up 1.5. We'll come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finished down 80, NASDAQ up 19, S&P's flat. Bottom line is that you had a sideways market out here with light volume, folks. We're going to take a look at the S&P. For what you're going to see out here is that you're slamming right into the October 10th, the downdraft. The top of that is $286.91. We hit 286.23 today. Bottom line, you did 38 million shares. Yesterday, you did 77 million. So you can see this some major resistance right here, and we'll see whether you're just building cars to get up and over it, or in fact just can't handle the price. That was your S&P. NDX 100 is the same type of setup. Now the differential in the SC, the NDX, is that that hasn't reached the high yet of the 21st of March. That's 182.83. We got to 182.90 today. You closed at 182.73. Bottom line is that, yeah, you have light volume, 21 million versus 42. Now, that you can say is a subtle failure, pretty intense, but it's still laying at the high. Small caps are still the weakest indice out here. You had a sideways move out there, slightly lower, far down 40 cents, 154.36. The differential is that the small caps made it to the downdraft of the 22nd of March. Now, that was the second downdraft because the small caps had topped out and this last get-go on February 25th. So the date we're talking here is on March 22nd. Got above it, closed underneath it, 40 million shares versus 17 today. So that is a failure in spades, too. Notes and bonds, they can use some more volume out here. What we did do is that you had price going up six ticks, no big deal there, but bottom line, you're going to need more volume. You are in the higher range, though. That's the bottom line. You know, we came down yesterday. You came down with heavy volume yesterday. That being said, it's still much lighter than the volume that you went topside with. You know, if we take a look at this, what you're going to see is that you're coming into the strength. The strength had 2.5 million contracts in the 10-year. We did 1.7. So when you do something like that, bottom line, that is saying, guess what? You still want higher price, lower yield. And good old King Dollar. King Dollar traded up to a price point of 97.095 today, 13,000 contracts. The high I was looking for is 97.160. And the bulls and bears are still fighting it out over at King Dollar. And it's actually all about the euro. The euro is right at its lows. That's trading 111.99. We'll see whether it wants to jump off the cliff. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted.
Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look, oh, it's a beautiful day. Got our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We gonna take him by storm?
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But yeah. Holy I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We have 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Surrender. Let go of the past. Whatever life takes away from you, let it go. When you surrender and let go of the past, you allow yourself to be fully alive in the moment. Letting go of the past means that you can enjoy the dream that is happening right here, right now. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials down 79. NASDAQ up 19. S&P's off 2.5. Bottom line, you get a flat sideways market out here. Really light volume. S&P's having a hard time catching any traction. The volume contracted, folks, in a pretty dramatic way, actually. Let me just see the volume in the indices out here. The ETF structures, in the indices also. We only did $778 million inside the NYSE. That is anemic in a huge way. NASDAQ Composite, $2 billion. And, bottom line is that you're going into about 2.2 to 2.4. Gold contract up $1.80, trading at $12.96 an ounce. You got silver $15.07, flat silver market. What silver did do, and this is really pretty cool what it did, it rejected lower price. Let's pull it up. We had got down, I think, to the $14.90 level. So it got under the lows the last 3 days, as well as under the swing point. Rejected it and then closed out at the high of the day. Yeah, you get down to 1490. So, and then you closed inside the 1498, and that's what you had to do because that was the swing point that we broke last Thursday, and that was a break with conviction too. We were coming into your strength from December 26th, and that's when we went from $14.88 to $15.32. That's what we need inside the metals market because that silver has been a laggard for a long period of time. It's much more highly volatile, no doubt, than the rest of the metals out here. Let's go take a look at the copper market because what has happened is that the copper market was the first metal market to basically get its head up. Copper was trading in January 3rd at $2.55 a pound. You're at $2.90 right now. This is a good setup. This is a setup that looks like this thing wants to get up into and over $3. So yesterday you go higher with 83,000 contracts. You pulled it back today in 55. That's a good setup. Notes and bonds, bottom line is that they went higher today. You're going to need a little more volume in them. What we had happen out here yesterday is that you had the note and bond market come down into their strength, dramatically lighter volume. Today, what we do, you go topside, volume's light, though. With 7 ticks, topside inside the 10-year, you're at 123.27. 30-year up 8 ticks, you're at 148.15. and King Dollar. Oh, let's take a look at King Dollar. King Dollar is still trying to get up into, up into the highs from March 7th. DXM9. So let's see what we did here. Okay, so the high was 97.160. You got to 97.095. Right now, no volume. 13,500 contracts. That we should have contract volume up there, folks, somewhere in the aspect of, you're talking about 25, 30,000 contracts. Now, if we do go take a look at the euro, and that's what's basically driving the dollar higher. The euro is 60% of the dollar index, folks. And what you have out here is that the euro broke the $1.12 today. Right now we're $1.1201, $1.1216 is the number. Now it didn't break with conviction, you know, as we did on the March 7th. But that euro, if you get a break with conviction, that'd be saying that the dollar would go quite higher. Now, the way that the dollar index is set up, that's telling me that, no, we're going to fail again up here. So somehow, some way, it looks like the euro will save itself. And I'm taking that from the aspect of how the dollar only has 13,000 contracts at those highs. Because you ground it up, but you just don't have conviction at those highs. And without conviction, bottom line, it doesn't take much to turn around and go south in a heartbeat. Inside the NDX 100, the strength versus the weakness out here today, Wynn Resorts. Wynn Resorts was up by 4.4%. Now, Facebook caught a bid, big time, too. Let's take a look at Facebook. So Facebook was up $5.50. This is getting over its highs, 174.29. It went to 174.90. And let me put this on a weekly. Okay, it's not going to be an ABC up, that's for sure. Well, see, it's Tuesday. You're going to need about 30 million shares. And, yeah, you're only at 10. Yeah, there's not going to be an ABC up. Two equities that are ABC ups, folks. Wynn Resorts, this had a big day out here, second day of a big day. This took out a B point with volume. This is going to help the NDX 100, there's no doubt. 133.70 was the B point. This took it out in spades, too. And 133, I forgot what this is. Yeah, it's like $40, $45. So it's 154, and Wynn's only at 135. And Las Vegas Sands is set up the same way. And I suspect this took out the B point of 62.56. You're at 64.85. This is a beauty, too. So 62.47, $15 gets you 73. And you're at 64.85. And that's going to be all about Macau, China, and the amount of money that they're making there. And if you do look at the Shanghai, you're going to see the Shanghai also went topside coming off the lows from January 4th. And the Shanghai, folks, had been going down for one full year. It was going down from February of 2018 down to January of 2019. So it looks to me like you get China off the lows. That's going to help Macau, China. That's going to help Wynn. And Las Vegas Sands, the real question is going to be, is that, okay, what wants to pull this baby lower? Because S&Ps are just laying right at the October 10th level. NDX 100, even though those two stocks are strong, bottom line, hasn't been able to make it over the highs of 2 weeks ago. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find market insights under trading newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to GameStop. GameStop, of course, it's a specialty electronic game store. And this has been having a hard time for a long period of time now because guess what? There's a lot more to games than going to a store and buying them. Low for the year is $10. The high is 17. It closed at $10.10. This is trading right now at 9:27. So this looks like it's gonna, it's gonna blow out. Another swing low. Ooh, man, look at this chart. You talk about a one-way route. Yeah, this is, so pitch this. This is pretty amazing, actually. I haven't seen something like this for a while. So we're back at 2005 levels. 2005, GameStop was at $10. By 2008, it was at 62. 2012, it was 15. Then it did a monster counter trend bounce, gets up to 57. And 2013 has been going south since then. Put this back just a little bit more. Yeah, this is going to be just 100% move for a move, and more than likely we'll see if they can stay in business. Let's see what they're saying. So they still employ a lot of people, and they still make money. Okay, so it's pretty amazing, actually. So they took in $3.1 billion. They don't have any growth markets. Let's see what they have to say. Okay, so their year comp sales, they're looking for that to be down from 5 to 10%. They're looking for their sales to be down from 5 to 10%. This comp, this quarter, that's year over year. This quarter, they had estimated that they would be down 2.1%, but they're actually saying that they were up 1.4%. New hardware sales is down 9.8%. Software sales are down 7.8%. Digital receipts were up 4.7%. Net sales, the estimate had been $3.27 billion. They came in with $3 billion. They came in with 100 profit improvement incentive, or they're reporting 100 profit improvement incentive. Bottom line is that they got some major problems. The amazing part is that they're still taking in that kind of money. If we just take a look at this again. Okay, so, yeah, every major part of that what they're selling looks like it's going down. New video game software is decreasing by over a three-year period at 5%. Pre-owned and value video is decreasing by 3%. That's not bad. New video hardware is decreasing by 4%. Technology brands is an increase by 15%. Now, that's going to be intriguing to see what that is, because so they take in $8.3 billion a year. And what you do have is that this is not a big part of it. It's only $803 million, but you start growing something at a billion clip at 15%, you can get some action there. So we'll see where that shakes out. They've been on the downbeat for a long period of time. Facebook out here today got traction. Not quite sure how. Well, they were buying it. That's the bottom line. And it looks like you get a small ABC structure on the way up too at Facebook. Yeah, the conservative way of doing it would be about, let's see, 45 to. It's about $27, which would end up getting you about $177. Right now you're at $174. Amazon, we take a look at Amazon. Amazon flat market today. We'll see how Whole Foods, the Amazon's cutting their prices, huge amount of goods at Whole Foods, including meats, by 20% tomorrow. If we look at Kroger, what you're going to see, this is the biggest grocery store out there. Oh, look at this. It did it today. This is dangerous. You got an ABC down. Wow. Okay, let's check this out. So, see, this was reported yesterday, and Kroger actually held up yesterday. Kroger just went from 24, was, you know, basically going sideways at $24. Now, you have... Boy, this is intense. Let me look at this. You know what you can have here? You have an ABC. This is pretty wild, man. This is big. $29. No, it's $6. Okay, so $6, it gets you $18. $18, man, this thing wants to go to. And you get a high volume low at 20. Let's see what's at 18. Well, your bottom of the swing point, we've been in the consolidation for a while, is $19.69. This thing's going south. And let's go Sprout, SP. Sprout Pharma Market. Now, this baby had got hit yesterday because this is a very small company, folks, in the aspect of, but it's a direct competitor with Whole Foods. And this is in trouble too. Yeah. So this one here, this is down from, you know, $37 in 2015. This is going after we'll see how it handles. $20 for a 17 is game though. And I wouldn't want to be in that whole food business right now? Because you're talking about substantial. When the announcement came out yesterday that they're going down, that was one thing, okay? When it came out this morning that you're going down, you know, on the vegetables and all this, okay, 20% is a big number. 20% on the meat, folks, is huge because meat's so expensive. And if they're doing that in fish, too, which I suspect they may be, that's gonna bring them pretty close to many supermarkets out there. And, you know, as long as they keep the quality of that food up, they're gonna get some runs for their money. There's no two ways about that. Google, let's go take a look at Google. Google out here trading $1,200 and this little baby, let's take a look at this. Yeah, this can test 1273. That high has some volume out here. It's going to be intriguing watching this thing shake out, because what you still have is that this market still has anemic volume as we're coming into the downdrafts. You know, when you do look at a couple of these NDX stocks, though, meaning, you know, you got Wynn doing an ABC structure, you got Las Vegas Sands, you got Facebook. You know, if that's what you got, it's going to be hard to hold that NDX down. Stay right here, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial, so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. So When we take a look at the ETF structures, type of volume we came in with, you're going to see the SPY, we came in with 39 million. Bottom line, yesterday we did 77, you're going into 214 million. NDX 100, the three Qs. Three Qs came in with 22 million. Yesterday we did 30. Now, the difference with the Qs is that the Qs had hit a high out there on the 21st of March. That high was 182.83. And that had 42 million. You can see, hey, listen, we'll find out what, we'll see what comes in tomorrow. But today, there's no doubt that it was anemic volume up at these highs, meaning no buyers. Diamonds, same setup. And pretty amazing at the diamonds. The diamonds yesterday had 6 million shares. Today, 2.2 million. Bottom line, just not enough juice going on. Let's go over, we'll shift gears into the gold market out here. We'll go take a look at Newmont. So Newmont, bottom line, folks, is that that's getting closer to taking over Goldcorp. And bottom line is that Newmont's trading $35.83. And let's just see how this shakes out, because it's price-wise on, let me see this here, folks. Okay, so price-wise, we get 35.83 times 0.3782 Okay, so right now, Goldcorp is at 11.47. So you're 30 cents. It's trading 30 cents away from the actual takeover. Now, if we take a look at Newmont, what you're going to see here, this is a nice setup. Newmont wants to go up and basically go after this high volume swing high that it has, the 22nd of February, which is pretty cool, because we bring this back a bit. What you're going to see is that if we can launch that area, you know, you're going to be up at $41, man. It's a big number. And if we go over the first equity that has launched the not the first equity that's launched the consolidation, because what we do have is we have Royal Gold way over that. But this is impressive. You got Wheaton River. Well, it used to be Wheaton River. Man of God, that is a long time ago. In fact, you know, check this out, folks. This is pretty amazing. It's time blows my mind, no doubt. Okay, so it's April 2nd, right? I started the gold report. I just looked at the first gold report a couple days ago. I started the gold report April 7th of 2002. Yes, 17 years ago. That's amazing. And that's when it used to be Wheaton River. They spun off a couple of them. Anyway, Wheaton Precious Metals, that took out this consolidation in spades, by the way. So your probability is the rest of these equities are going to come up and follow through. If we go take a look at Royal Gold, which is one of the strongest ones out here, Royal's at 91.46. I believe the high is 101. Yeah, $100.84. But you can see what's so intriguing here about Royal Gold is that we're just about at the highs of 2012. And gold, okay, if we do this correlation, what you're going to see is that gold is way off its highs, okay? We're talking about a whole different animal here. You know, the high in gold that was generated out here was this 1920 on a continuous contract. We're at 1290. Now, that's really impressive that Royal Gold is up this high. What does happen also is that, let's go to FNV. All of these that I'm pulling up right now, including Wheaton Silver, Wheaton Precious Metals, they're streaming stocks, meaning they're royalty stocks. That's how they're making their money. Well, we'll keep it at that. Wheaton River actually is a broker, but they have a streaming aspect also. If we go back to Franco-Nevada, you're going to see Franco-Nevada. The high of Franco-Nevada is 86. You're at 74. This is a nice high-end consolidation. And, you know, when you do have these high-end consolidations and the fact of the matter is that you have, these are streamers. What tends to happen is that when these babies go higher, folks, okay, your metal most of the time is going to follow them up. And the reason, I don't know who follows who, but the bottom line is that it's your probability is pretty good that the metal's going to keep going. The reason being is that the risk inside a streamer, they don't have political risk. Well, they have political risk. They always have political risk because if they, someone shuts down the mine, that's political risk. They do, what they don't have is ore risk, and bottom line, they don't have exploration risk because what the streamers do is that you're in the gold business. You find a bunch of gold. They will finance that to get that up and going, and then they're taking a percentage of the gold off the top, off the gross amount. And off the gross amount is totally where it's at. And the way some of these contracts are made is that as the price of gold goes higher, their royalty actually goes higher. Not in all the deals, but there's plenty of them that I've seen. And you can see those deals. Those deals are public information. They're public information. Most of the time, they're inside the filings with the SEC. So it's pretty cool. I remember the first time I read a few of them. It's pretty wild, actually. And then, it's really wild, too, is that the fight, folks, when I was going over the first gold report, I was looking at it as the amount of equities that are in the gold report now that are still were in at the first. And one of them, this is what the fight was over Newmont. If you remember, you had Newmont and you had Barrick. And then you had Goldcorp. And what was going on is that Barrick was saying that Newmont is, basically blowing it buying Goldcorp because Goldcorp, the assets in Goldcorp wasn't worth what they were paying. Well, what had happened is this, is that we look at Goldcorp, and we knew this when this happened, folks. Goldcorp, great company. They had and still have one of the most precious metal mines in Red Lake, okay? When I say one of the most precious metals, mean that they can get gold out of the ground at a very inexpensive price. Well, what happened is that Goldcorp ended up buying Glamis, and that was a really sweet score for all of us in the gold report. And you could see at the time, this is where the euphoria was taking place because gold was just moving up so dramatically. They overpaid for Glamis like in a huge way. And guess what? We sold it, we're out of there. But that is what has come back to haunt them. Now, this gold corp's going to go through with Newmont, so I guess it's not going to haunt them that bad. But that is why you see an aspect of, gold corp topped out in 2011 at $56. You're trading $11.47. You can see there's a differential that's pretty dramatic when I just brought up the other streamers, and the streamers are basically pretty close to their highs. Now, not all of them are close to their highs like that, but even if we bring up Barrick, which Barrick had been a dog for years, and it's got a little pop now, but Barrick, actually it's almost the same ratio. Barrick's down from $53 and you're at $13.46. Stay right there, folks, come right back.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Directions Daily S&P Biotech 3x Bull and Bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion.
While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns, as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Let's go take a look at Blue Apron holdings here. So Blue Apron, the low for the year is 65 cents. The high is $4.15. Now, this went public, folks, June 28th, 2017, at $10. And this was one of the first ones that they were pushing out there. They almost knew that it was going to be a tough one right from the get-go. Let's see what they're having to say here. They are replacing their president and CEO, effective April 8th. They got a new CEO that's going to be coming in. Dickerson is going to, so Brad Dickerson is the one who basically is resigning. He's a co-founder. Then you get another co-founder. Interesting. Yeah, they're basically both. Co could be more than two. Too. Bottom line, you get two co-founders. They're resigning. You get the chief technology officer is also resigning April 3rd. They are reaffirming guidance of a significant improvement in net loss. Net loss. Oh my God. So this equity was trading in. Oh, that's not the equity. Okay, APRN. That was just the S&Ps. So that closed at 96 cents. That's trading right now at $1.12. And if we take a look at this, we have 2,300 employees. They just have losses as far as you can see. So check this out. This is pretty amazing, actually. So they're already contracting by 8% over a three-year period. In 2015, they took in $340 million. 2018, they took in $667. 2019, they're looking to take in $572. And right out to 2020, you actually do not see profit at all. So it's like pretty amazing. They went. Pull this back. So they went public at $10. Yeah, this was the one, man. This is a sick scene. Now, wait till you see this, folks. Yeah, this is when, you know, what's supposed to happen, the due diligence and IPOs, you know, is supposed to be quite extensive. And you can see in this particular IPO, there's no way it was, because I just brought this back. to the first day of the IPO. The high of is $11. The following week, the stock's at $7.36. The week after that, it's at $7.08. It never got to higher than $7.80 after that. And then all you have to do is go back. This is pretty amazing, actually. Go into 13 weeks, and you're down to $3. Go another 13 weeks, you're down to $1.72. Go 26 weeks, and then you're down to 65 cents. Oof. That is intense. There's no doubt. And the amount of shares, let's see who's taking the hits out here. So yeah, equity-wise, well, you get Fidelity. Fidelity owns 2.4% of it. That's not a killer for them, that's for sure. That's going to be probably inside just one of their funds. Yeah, so there goes IPO, LYFT. What do we got on Lyft? This is unusual. This is unusual for it to get under it low and stay under it for a couple of days, where it went to $66 today. And when you do look at Lyft intraday, it almost looks like, you know, this thing could get down to 61. You know, if we get the market pulls back at all, which I expect we're going to see, you'll have $61 on this Lyft, and you'll get it down there, I suspect, pretty quick. What did catch a bid out here last night, if you woke up this morning, folks, we haven't talked about this in so long, it's amazing, was Bitcoin. You know, our man Jim from Minneapolis called yesterday when Tommy and I were on the air in the morning. And bottom line, he had seen this thing just picking its head up. Now, when he called, Bitcoin was only trading at about $4,100. Overnight, this went to $5,078. It's trading $4,800 right now. And what it did, it launched the whole consolidation. When I say the whole consolidation, when you bring it all the way back to November of 2018. You know, the top of this consolidation was somewhere around 4,500 to 4,600. Goes to 48. We pull this back a little bit more. Yeah, I mean, it looks like, you know, we're going to be dealing with 83 Bitcoin, and that can be pretty quick, because all that would do, you know, bottom line is that's when it dropped out of bed. After building cars for, you know, about a half a year, dropped out of bed, gets down to a low of 31.36. So 31.36 thus far is the low that had been established in Bitcoin thus far. And, of course, the high was 19,511. That's what I have. I know it was somewhere around 20,000, but on this chart, it's 19,511. And all of the cryptos, you know, not just Bitcoin, folks, did start going topside today. So we'll see if, in fact, they can get some juice behind them. I can't picture how you can trade them, because it just seems that the horror shows that are out there, the amount of horror shows that are out there, that you could actually, you put your money in, you make money, then all of a sudden try to get your money out, and whether they lose the wallets, they lose the Bitcoins, they lose the digital, something always seems to happen. You know, so it is what it is. And, you know, we'll see. Our man Paul from Henderson called out here this morning. Now, one of the trades he was in, this is kind of Riot blockchain. And these will start moving again, too. The low for the year is $1.20. The high is $9.75. This broke topside today, went all the way up to $5.15. And this is an equity. When you read the description of it, you know, they're saying they do everything, okay? The company focuses on buying cryptocurrency and blockchain businesses, as well as supports blockchain technology companies, Riot Blockchain, and also maintains its existing biotech business. When you take a look at the amount of money they take in, it's minimal, folks. I think it's $267,000 a quarter. Yeah, oh, no, 2.8 million. 2.4 million a quarter. No. Oh, this is interesting. Yeah, no, that'd be right. 2.4 million. They went from 269,000 last year, 1,000 in a whole year. 1,000. And let me see this. This is like crazy when this happens. And so this has a market cap of $63 million. This doesn't even make any sense, man. Bottom line, Paul, make sure that you get in and out of this on a daily basis, because this just doesn't make any sense. And they, you know, as far as they're out, the numbers that we have is that this still going to lose money too. What blows my mind is this number right here, though, that you can actually be a public company and take in $198,000 a year, $96,000 a year. Are you kidding me? Dow Industrials finished down 79, NASDAQ up 19, S&P's flat. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. And I would say that in the airline business, folks, there's a lot we don't know that we're kind of learning pretty quickly here. Boeing's got another problem out here. Let's check this out. This is amazing, actually. So the Air Force has halted delivery of the Boeing tankers over debris. These are brand new tankers, folks. So the LA Air Force has stopped accepting the deliveries of Boeing's new refueling tanker aircraft for the second time in a month because of debris found in closed compartments, according to Secretary of the Air Force Heather Wilson. The halt in deliveries of the KC-46A Pegasus is the latest issue to plague the $44 billion effort to create the first U.S.-built flying gas station since the KC-10 extender in 1981. her quote is that we actually stopped again. She said, because we found foreign objects in closed compartments of the aircraft. Elaborating on the trash left behind by the workers, Wilson told the House Appropriations Subcommittee later in the day that it was a manufacturing discipline issue in the assembly line where we saw a breakdown. And here's the issue. If you drop a wrench, you have to find the wrench, she said. You have to wipe down the surfaces so you don't have pieces of aluminum all over the all that over time get in the midst of things and can cause serious problems. The latest delivery halt was prompted after the service opened some closed compartments, such as inside the wings, and found flaws, she said, without elaborating. It's pretty intense, man. You know what's pretty intense is that you think that you're delivering a plane. You're delivering a house. And when you're delivering a house, of course, you have the inspection. You know, you go over it a million times to make sure everything's all right. They're delivering planes at, what, $30, $40, $50 million, and someone is not going over them to make sure that it's all right. It's pretty amazing, man. I mean, now, this right here, it hasn't hit Boeing after the close. You know, Boeing's still in trouble, period, meaning even technically. Boeing closed at $390.75. That thing is not done going south. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. We look forward to speaking right back here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Wow! Go get them, folks.